smart, you'd run and protect yourself from a demon living in the dark. There's nothing to be gained, 'cause I can never change, and you can never understand my sickness.
We are in Kynes Grove. Let's go ahead and get started. Welcome back to Skyrim Weekly. I'm Angel. This is Gaming with Angels, and we're running up a hill. I'm going to go ahead and grab my travel lantern because it's foggy as shit. That is a deer. Hopefully the area will clear up a little bit. See if we can get up this mountain without, you know, being stupid about it. I'm gonna be stupid about it. Awesome.
This is what us Nords were always meant to do. Traverse the province and right wrongs with strength, steel, and resolve.
Oh, well, that's not good. Alduin's a prick.
Salukun here. Zeal gro dova ulsa.
I can't help but wonder how East wants
steady. I don't know what's happening. Let's watch and wait. This is worse than I thought.
Helmet? Not mean to pick that up, but okay.
It's true, isn't it? You really are Dragonborn.
I owe you some answers, don't I? Go ahead. Whatever you want to know. Nothing. I'm one of the last members. A very long time ago, the Blades were Dragon Slayers, and we served the Dragonborn. The greatest dragon slayer. For the last 200 years since the last dragonborn emperor, the Blades have been searching for a purpose. Now that dragons are coming back, our purpose is clear again. We need to stop them. The first thing we need to do is figure out who's behind the dragons. The Thalmor are our best lead. If they aren't involved, they'll know who is. Nothing solid, yet. But my gut tells me it can't be anybody else. The Empire had captured Ulfric. The war was basically over. Then a dragon attacks, Ulfric escapes, and the war is back on. And now the dragons are attacking everywhere, indiscriminately. Skyrim is weakened. The Empire is weakened. Who else gains from that but the Thalmor? If we could get into the Thalmor Embassy, it's the center of their operations in Skyrim. Problem is, that place is locked up tighter than a miser's purse. They could teach me a few things about paranoia. I'm not sure yet. I have a few ideas, but I'll need some time to pull things together. Meet me back in Riverwood. If I'm not back when you get there, wait for me. I shouldn't be long. Keep an eye on the sky. This is only going to get worse. Do you need something?
We killed a dragon. That was incredible. Everything they said about you, it's all true. I didn't even think of that. Gods, this must have all come as an enormous shock to you. If anyone can stop the dragon threat, it's clearly you, Thane. And I'll do everything I can to help.
Yay! Our relationship has improved with Delphine. Totally okay with that. That is a fox. Alright. So, the dialogue add-on for Lydia is quite helpful because it's... as much as I love Amorous Adventures, it's kind of rapey. And, you know, you're like, you must be Lydia, my new house Carl. Let's sleep together. And done. So, that's kind of how that one works. But it's... little bit of a nightmare, and I just can't. So, I don't.
Did you see my husband already? I'm sorry. He can come off a bit rough.
Get rid of the light on my butt. And it's... I just can't do that. I mean, Lydia's, character is there to serve you, yes, and it's, I'm here to carry your burdens, but, you know, hi, you're Lydia, that means you serve me, polish my knob. That's not how this works. If anything, I think they should, you know, add on something that asks Lydia if she's actually okay with, you know, being basically a servant.
Even if you don't, you're still welcome.
Yes. Sure thing. It's yours for a day. I'll show you to your room. Right this way.
So, go ahead and get Jack some sleep here because...
Let me know if there's anything else you need.
Lydia, come here.
Where to first? Giving the Greybeards back the horn or back to Riverwood?
So we're gonna go to bed.
For the darkness has passed and the legend yet grows.
Just gonna wait for her to get in bed first. But so, yeah, I'm just not okay with this whole like. And they did this kind of the same thing with Serana's, you know. Well, looky, looky, what we have here. I'll take you back if you'll sleep with me, type thing. And then she's like, just kidding. It's. There really could have been some better development to that, definitely. So, I mean, that's my personal opinion about it. You guys might have a different opinion, but that's just kind of weirded out by it. So, you know, went through, found this Lydia voice add-on, and it makes you work for it, and I mean, work for it. If you don't choose the right answers in the add-on, you totally friend zone yourself, and it sucks. But you know, the first time I played through it, it was like, had to really think about some of those answers, and it's like, there are definitely consequences to your actions. So, definitely gonna have to put this one up as a mature content, but you know, whatever. Like I said, maybe that's like your thing. I don't know. I just... I can't do it.
You don't dabble in magic much, do you? Can't say I blame you. I barely trust any of it myself.
I'll never understand why you're so bitter.
What do
about
you need,
everything.
Handsome?
I'm bitter because we had lives in Cyrodiil, and we came out here to be paupers.
Excuse me. I really do not want to hear the hens, bitch. So I'm actually going to go to the Greybeards first. And
you're going
then
to try
we'll...
and sell me something? I ain't interested. You
That's
lost.
Cool. And then we'll go tackle Delphine and her issues. Let's mark things first. Go ahead and travel to High Hrothgar and give them back the horn so I can get the third word for Unrelenting Force. Your two beautiful babes that are above my head here. Yes. Yes. Life is good. So am I...
Where to first? Giving the Greybeards back the horn or back to the river?
My quest to find new games to showcase here on Gaming with Angels, I've come across a new one that actually isn't going to be released until next month. And I got a hold of the game writer. And he's totally open for us to showcase that. So that's going to be coming up. And I'll put that information out later. But it's going to be... Ball Boys. It's a multi-level or multiplayer parkour game. It's actually very interesting what I have come across in reading on the descriptions and stuff like that.
Ah, you've retrieved the horn of Jorgen Rimkon. Well done. You have now passed all the trials. Come with me. It is time for us to recognize you formally as Dragonborn.
Thane. They may not be the typical image of true Nords, but the Greybeards deserve equal respect.
You are ready to learn the final word of Unrelenting Force. Da, which means push.
Da.
With all three words together, this shout is much more powerful. Use it wisely. Master Wolfgar will now gift you with his knowledge of Da. Between us and prepare yourself. Few can withstand the unbridled voice of the Greybeards, but you are ready.
Vindra crosses Saran, Strundul, both in Halan, Glow, Ral, now.
Sulek to Khan, Al Sulek to Shur, Al Nar Sulek to Atmorasmur. Dovahkiin. You have tasted the voice of the Greybeards and passed through unscathed. High Hrothgar is open to you.
Right behind you.
Sweet. Did you know there's a bed you can sleep in here? It's like up this way, I think. So if you come up here...
You're not good with the unconventional kind of fighting, are you? Neither am I.
Well, I don't remember.
But I'll admit that it works better sometimes.
Anyway, there is a place in here where you can actually rest. Rather than being, you know, or renting a room at Iverstead, since, you know, you can't buy any property in Iverstead, which sucks, but
so
it is what it is.
Real armor too heavy for you?
One of these areas up here, you can actually, find a bed and sleep in it, so. Anyway, back to Riverwood. That's where we're going right now. And it's pissing me off. Awesome. Oh my god, that is so pretty. The big thing about doing the vanilla in this one is to make sure that you guys can hear the whole thing for the Lydia add-on. At certain sequences during the game, she has open dialogue available. She's gonna bitch you out because she doesn't like Delphine. That's a spoiler for you. And just all kinds of stuff, and she gets all excited because you get to go fight Alduin and things like that. As far as the anthology, the Illyrius anthology, I've been kind of keeping you updated on that, and we're working on taming the vocals that's in it, because we actually have some voice acting and stuff that is coming into that. Super excited. Lots of things that are going to happen with the Illyrius anthology. Making sure that there's, you know, all of the mods that are going into it are working correctly, including the ones that we've developed. And you'll see. Just trust me, you'll see. It's going to be great. It's going to be fantastic.
Right, Bob.
Go ahead and do this real quick while I'm thinking about it.
Do you?
There you are. I've been looking everywhere for you. I've got this thing I'm supposed to deliver. Your hands only. Let's see.
Contrary to
Looks like that's all. I have to leave.
There's actually plenty of game out on the tundra. It's a great place to hunt.
That's fair. I had to pay my taxes. No big deal.
Later, little one. I need to finish what I'm
doing. I'm gonna sell some shit.
But keep watching. Watch.
Relinquish some of this weight, like the dragon scales I just picked up. I don't actually need those right now.
Thank you so much for taking care of those. You and me, we're the only people. Oh, a bit of this and a bit of that.
Bye. Oh yeah, I should probably drop that off.
Till next time.
Perfect.
Still here.
Yes, yes, you are. All right.
Fane.
Let's go to Delphine and see what she has to say.
What can I do for you, friend?
There is an amorous adventure here in Riverwood. It's a huge love triangle that you can completely debunk.
Welcome. Let me know if you want anything. I think I got a clean mug around here somewhere.
I don't think you were followed. Come on, I have a plan.
Every time I think about what happened to Rongar's wife and daughter, I'm glad we gave Movarth and Alva what they deserved.
I figured out how we're going to get you into the Thalmor Embassy. I've been doing this a long time, remember? While the Thalmor have been looking for me, I've been watching them. The Thalmor ambassador, Elenwyn, regularly throws parties where the rich and connected cozy up to the Thalmor. I can get you into one of those parties. Once you're inside the embassy, you can get away and find Elenwyn's secret files. I have a contact inside the embassy. He's not up for this kind of high-risk mission, but he can help you. His name is Malborn. Wood Elf. Plenty of reason to hate the Thalmor. You can trust him. I'll get word for him to meet you in solitude at the Winking Skeever. You know it? While you're doing that, I'll work on getting you an invitation to Elenwyn's little party. Meet me at the Solitude Stables after you've arranged things with Malborn. Any questions? That's when the fun starts. You'll have to slip away from the party without raising the alarm. Then you'll need to find Elenwyn's office and search her files. Malborn should be able to point you in the right direction. Let me handle that. You'll have a real invitation, don't worry. As long as you can act the part of a Thalmor toady, you'll get past the guards. Don't worry about Malborn. He's not a dangerous character like you. But he hates the Thalmor at least as much as I do. He's a wood elf. The Thalmor wiped out his family back in Valenwood during one of their purges that we never hear about. Luckily, they don't know who he really is, or he wouldn't be serving drinks at the ambassador's parties.
That's fair.
Sounds good. Be careful. What? Something you're still confused about?
Let's go.
What? Something you're still confused about?
Is there something I can do for you?
So basically, we're going to go back to Elysium Estates and find some decent party clothes, because the party clothes that Delphine gives us, they're shit. And it's, I'm going to drop off the cultist robes that I've already picked up and put those on one of the mannequins. But I do have some party clothes, I think. I don't know. I'll have to look, but the point is that I should have some. They give you those fancy clothes. The vanilla fancy clothes. And for me, that's just kind of a hard pass. They're even the vanilla fancy clothes for the female. Oh my god, those are hideous. Holy crap. You're like, yes, Terry, I know, my clothes suck, but this isn't much better. Which, you know, if you don't know Terry, or you're not familiar with the name, she's one of the sisters that runs Radiant Raiments in Solitude. She's pretty hot. Even with her bad attitude, she's pretty hot. But she's got a good reason for her bad attitude. If you're actually paying attention, you can figure out why. So, also refilled the water skins, you know, things like that. So to do this, I'm gonna have to give my clothes to Lydia. Okay, my party clothes, because I have to give everything over to I have to give everything over to Delphine that I don't give to what's his nuts to hold on to while I go and basically whore myself out to the Thalmor to get into their embassy.
Thane. Before she married my father, always told me to stay away from them. Never knew why, but I listened.
Beware, beware, the dragonborn comes. For the darkness has passed and the legend yet grows. You'll know the dragonborn's come.
So I went through
a farm in the plains here, but I wanted
the
to
cheat room and I picked up all of the Thieves Guild stuff. So this is what it would look like if you have all of the pieces. It's a Thieves Guild is one of my favorite things to do when I'm just playing. I might just do just the Thieves Guild and nothing else and pick up all of these pieces. But, you know, like things that are not easy to get, the goblet, the candlestick,
the record,
the golden ship, the ornate drinking horn, because they're all in, or there's several of them that are in solitude, specifically in Queen Elisif's chambers. Specifically, that's where they're actually at, and you have to steal them from her. So they're not, they're really not that easy to just go and get them. It is a nice setup, though, once you do get all of them. I am actually going to take the carriage to Solitude. Oh, wrong bodyguard. We'll see. Looks a lot like the bodyguard that should probably not be here, should be in Whiterun. The hired mercenary. Raining, he's up here at the stables, so. And he is, so.
I can take you to any of the hold. Where do you want to go? Climb and back, and we'll be off.
Yes, Dave. What is it?
This way, Jack can get some rest while he's, you know, traveling. Wake up refreshed. Yeah, 32 minutes. Neat. So, Ball Boys can be found, when it comes out in December, it'll be found on Steam. Would love for you guys to join in with me to play it. Like I said, it's multiplayer, so I want to figure it out before I join in with anybody and act like the fool, which I'll probably do anyway, but I'll let you guys know when that comes out. It's out by Jazz Apps, so I definitely want to check that out. They're so pretty. They just are. The girls are just so pretty. This is like one of my favorite dances. It's one of the funniest ones that they do. So. Poor Jack.
Need something?
Blackwood. It has been a long week. So I hope everybody is ready for the holidays. If you are celebrating Hanukkah, today is the 8th day of Hanukkah. Just so you guys know, I know this won't be posted until Wednesday, so I hope you guys had a great Hanukkah season. Kwanzaa's coming up, along with Yom Kippur, of course Christmas, and Pagan Yule. So whatever holiday that it is that you celebrate this month of the some 47 different holidays, happy holidays. From all of us here at the Gaming with Angels studio, definitely directly from me, happy holidays to each and every one of you. Let's see, this is 32, 33, 34. We'll be at 35 weeks when the Christmas episode comes out. So, not that it has anything to do with Christmas that week, where we're going to be at. I mean, who the hell knows where we're going to be at in 3 weeks? So, 2 weeks through, three weeks to, holy crap, it's 3 weeks till Christmas. That is insane. We're like sitting right on the curb of 8.5 months of putting out Skyrim Weekly alone. It's insane.
Still here.
Did you hear Uncle Bob here? Tell them he didn't do it.
Position.
Far, you need to go home. Go home and stay there until your mother.
Lock the city gate.
She's pretty. Look at that.
You should tell her that her uncle is
get on with it!
I'm not sure you are.
Best you know now.
All right. Rogner, you helped Ulfric Stormcloak escape the city after he murdered Hiking Tori. By opening that gate for Ulfric, you betrayed the people of Solitude.
He doesn't deserve to speak!
There was no murder.
Oh, liar!
He beat the High King in fair combat. Such is our way. Such is the ancient custom of Skyrim and all Nords.
I'm definitely going to have to mark this one for mature content. Especially because what's going to happen. And this is Noah. Rated M for mature.
On this day,
my father was in
I go to Sodom.
He said it got him off his place at Brazil and he spent his life there.
Squishy. Kick the body over.
If you're heading to the Blue Palace, you might want to rethink that outfit.
Some gate guard you are!
I will, but thank you. So, I'm an ass, and kind of an asshole, and one of the things that I did with Rodvir's body is I totally threw it in the well. That definitely happened. I've also taken his body and
so exciting when new folk come into town.
Threw it in there.
We've had plenty of adventures.
but I did. I totally dropped his body down that well. That happened. Definitely happened.
You know, the Winking Skeever's not just the best inn in Solitude.
Really do not want to talk to him because I have no intention of going back to Markarth right now. I'll be going to Markarth later, but not right this second. It has nothing to do with what I need to do right now. What I do want to show you guys is, and this is something I've kind of saved, is what we've done to the Winking Skeever. And this is a few different mods. All working in sync together. That it did take, it was a little bit challenging put this one together because it was some backdoor hacking and coding that we
come
had to work
on.
Just but check this out. Cold. Look at this shit.
Right
that,
behind you.
That is just freaking awesome. I mean, it's just like.
Hmm.
then of course you come over here and it's kind of like the vanilla side, but it gives him an actual bar to work at. You know, here's all the wenches, of course. One,
oh, did
two,
you need something?
And three.
And need what something? Might you need?
Hmm?
You looking for something or what?
If
look,
you need a good
I
rumor
really
or two,
you.
I think
okay,
I can oblige.
Okay, just this once.
Welcome to the Winking Skeever, friend.
This particular one, this one that says, what have you heard about Jarl Elisif? Assassins may find her easy prey. This one is what kicks off the Amorous Adventures for Elisif, just so you guys know.
Sure thing. It's yours for a day. I'll show you to your room. Right this way.
But we also made it a lot less, more constant that you could accidentally steal shit from here. So, I don't know if you've ever tried to, like, sit down or something like that, and you accidentally take a wooden plate or a goblet or, you know, whatever. It's kind of a pain in the ass.
For a stranger, you're not so bad.
Thanks, kid. Our room is over there, but there are certain things going on in that room right now that we are not going to go pay attention to. So, we're just going to kind of take a look-see around.
True, I may look the part of dashing swordsman, but I prefer the art of wit to that of warfare.
I'm sure you guys can hear in the background. You know, there's just different rooms that we've added into this. You know, so it actually looks like an inn, and it doesn't look like it only has, like, two rooms in basically the capital of Skyrim, you know?
You don't dabble in magic much, do you? Can't say I blame you. I barely trust any of it myself.
And this takes you out to the porch, at the upstairs porch for, the Winking Skeever. So this is kind of nice, but of course it's, you know, pissing rain, so right. God forbid. It's a nice little balcony area that you can sit at, watch the idiots, and the dead guy. There's always that too, so.
Still here, right behind you. Let's go. Still here. You definitely need it. God, you're going to get yourself hurt like that. Come over here.
So when she adjusts your armor plates, what happens is it actually gives you a little boost on your armor for a little while.
Still here.
Let me know if you need anything, or take a seat by the fire, and I'll send someone over.
That's kind of nice to have, too, so...
I have no business with you. Leave me.
No problem. So you have all this going on.
Maybe you can help me.
Okay.
But you can continue upstairs. And there is a loft room. Excuse me. You actually have to pickpocket the key. Which we're not going to do right now. Lydia, my love, you've got to move. Okay. So anyway, this room is still set up the same way as it is in Vanilla Skyrim. But, you know... My butt's still on fire.
Thane.
She's gonna go to bed. We're gonna meet with what's his nuts in the morning. Hopefully we don't have like 500 people like try to come in here. That would suck a little bit. Melbourne. That's who we're going to talk to in the morning. About giving him all of our shit so that we can go to the Thalmor Embassy.
You can't have your weapons on you.
Just so stupid, but well, you know, whatever. And it's summertime. Alright, mid-year, so it is June. Somebody else is getting laid. For what it's worth.
So, is real armor too heavy for you? I'll just...
You lost?
In a voice with the power of the ancient Lord. You did good with the fit. The dragonborn
comes. Look alive, will you?
So, anyway, this is a nice one. I'm going to wait for her to...
You want a drink? All right, then.
Need something? Really? You're who she picked? I hope she knows what she's doing. Here's the deal. I can smuggle some equipment into the embassy for you. Don't plan on bringing anything else in with you. The Thalmor takes security very seriously. Give me what you can't live without, and I'll make sure to get it into the embassy. The rest is up to you. Okay, I'll get this inside the embassy for you. I've gotta go. I'll find you at the party. Don't worry.
Now I'm sitting here, I'm completely naked, and I gotta go get some clothes. I'm not really worried about my septums too much, because I'm actually gonna have Lydia hold on to those. I'm actually gonna give her a bunch of my stuff to hold on to. But...
Your job is to get into the party without being fingered as a spy. I'll take care of the rest.
Okay. To rethink my clothes, and I'm not wearing any.
Still here.
Man, this looks nice.
Between you and me.
Really? We aren't interested in seeing all that. Remove yourself until you are properly attired.
Clothes and raiment for the discerning customer.
Basically, she's pissed because I'm in here and I'm naked. But there's like nothing I can do about it right this second, so. Ooh. Ooh.
Finally.
It's not too shabby. You know? Definitely better than that other shit they give us.
I'm more of a heavy armor woman myself. But it's nice to carry... Thane.
Definitely gonna make sure she has that on hand.
Let's go.
Get out of solitude. And when we come back next week, it's party time with the Thalmor. You find out how much I fucking hate the Thalmor. Just absolutely hate them. So this is Jack, this is Lydia, and I'm Angel, and I will see you guys next week. Thanks for watching, everybody.
From Dragon or Giant, we'll
stay tuned. You'll see. More to come.